This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Back to the future. Polaroids are hot.
Gives them a chance to sort of live out Instagram in real life.
Above it all, drones deliver for this local company.
You're able to express something unique that may not have been able to be accomplished before.
Plus, an ongoing family portrait.
My goal is to raise them to be strong, confident, brave women.
And the daring man who snapped Hitler's photo.
He was sure he was about to be arrested.
Stories from behind the lens, next on Chronicle.
Good evening. We live, of course, in an on-demand society. We want what we want, when we want it, like right now.
You got it, Anthony. In 1972, the Polaroid camera delivered that instant gratification. Now the instant camera is back for the Instagram generation.
On any given Friday, you can find tweens across Massachusetts gathering to party like it's 1972. That's the year modern instant color photography took off, and now...
It's making a real resurgence. I mean, I'm selling more of them now than I think I ever did, even when Polaroid was producing millions of them.
Steve Sentimore and his family have been running Bromfield Camera, nestled between Downtown Crossing and the Common, for 52 years.
It's funny. We buy used ones, and we get them from the older people. And then we turn around and clean them up and we sell them to the younger people.
I went and bought an old Polaroid camera for not too much money and just started experimenting with it and found something really satisfying about the way the photos come out.
Frank Manuel is among those bringing the art of Polaroid back into the limelight with a modern twist. He posts his Polaroid instant photos on Instagram under the name Boston Polaroid.
I used it as an opportunity to show off things that I really love in the city of Boston, taking photos of landmarks and the not so famous parts of town. The things that people might overlook, Polaroids really bring out that subtle beauty.
But it's not only artists who are driving Instant's rebirth.
Definitely see that the Fuji Instax in particular has taken off with some younger folks because it gives them a chance to sort of live out Instagram in real life and take a photo that looks like it's been through a filter, but they've got a physical object that they can touch.
A colorful Fuji Instax camera is under $100, or you can go retro with a Polaroid Originals, made in the Netherlands, but featuring the name of the Boston-based company that started it all.
Polaroid's one step.
In fact, instant film was invented not more than probably 1,000 feet from where I am standing this very minute.
Debbie Douglas is the director of collections at the MIT Museum, where Polaroid artifacts are on permanent display. These early camera molds and first images, pioneered by Polaroid's genius creator Edwin Land, trace not just an epic change in photography, but a change in society itself.
Polaroid helps us make that transition from very fast to instant. You see the emergence of fast food, the internet, instant communications. But Polaroid itself is also one of the most iconic artifacts of that period.
And instant photography was an instant hit.
The actual rollout of the cameras as a consumer product came in November of 48. It was the day after Thanksgiving. Here in downtown Boston at the old Jordan Marsh store. They only had about 80 of these cameras. They thought that would last till Christmas. All sold that first day.
However, as many in the Commonwealth who lost jobs and pensions can tell you, Polaroid's fortunes didn't last. The company filed for bankruptcy in 2008 and stopped production on its iconic instant film in 2009.
The simple answer is, digital photography. It killed it. Well, that might be true, except Polaroid was one of the pioneers in digital photography. Probably more important is the one-hour photo developing studio that began to pop up at every drugstore on the corner. Waiting an hour versus a minute isn't that big a deal.
Despite the cause, instant photography was in trouble. But now, with a healthy influx of new young users, it's coming back. And as instant photo technology evolves, it seems fitting that a company with Polaroid roots, right here in Billerica, is leading the way.
Being able to print from a mobile device that fits in your pocket is something that we have seen a huge demand for.
Zinc stands for zero ink, and they make the inkless paper that can take your photos quickly from here to here, turning any cell phone into an instant memory-making machine. President J.C. Van Dyke, like much of Zinc's original staff, got his start at Polaroid. Their product has been around over 10 years, but improvements in mobile technology have led to significant growth.
People use it for scrapbooking. I hand out my own business cards with printed on Zinc. I think we are in the fun business. The primary use of Zinc is to do things that are social and fun.
And there is one thing that instant photography will always have that digital doesn't.
You can see it and you can touch it and you can handle it and pass it around. That's something that is a fun element of sharing.
That is so true. And an interesting note, instant photography isn't really so instant anymore. The original Polaroid used to take 1 minute to develop. Now it can take between 15 and 20 minutes.
Right, but the quality is much better, it seems like, after that 15 to 20 minutes, of course. And then the printing on the Fujifilm that we showed, that takes about 5 minutes. And the digital printing on the Zinc paper takes about a minute. So I guess it depends a little bit on your tolerance and a little bit on your quality interest as well.
I loved that Zinc paper. All right, once they got drones, this company took off.
We've been given a tool that frees us to literally fly.